to? Jamming?
Just dancing.
All right. And here's Mike. Mike's dancing. There he is. Say something. Say hi to Mom.
Never mind. Okay, let's walk back. Walk back this way. Everybody's dancing with each other. Cut right in here. Wow, isn't that great? And just want to remind you, phone number here is 659-4696. It's a fundraiser. We're trying to raise funds for an upcoming summer movie. Do this every year. This year has been a great success. Could be even more of a success if you pick up that phone and dial 659-4696 and pledge a couple dollars. Help us get through the summer. So let's just go back and Brandon will show you some more people dancing. Phone number again is 659-4696. Feel free to call.
Okay, we're back here in the dance right now. It's so ironic that this song just came on because this is a song that is like the number one music video of 96. And I was in it. I was a little band. I don't know if you ever saw it. I think it's coming up later tonight.
This hour.
I believe. So you'll see later tonight. You'll see what I mean. We are jamming here at this dance. Let me tell you. Everybody's dancing. Will Former's dancing. Matt Bradley has a clown.
Yep.
Two grooving DJs here. I'll be DJing later, and I'll be playing better music than this, okay? So don't worry. I don't mean to do this to you guys, but that's just the way it is sometimes, you know? One DJ takes better.
That's how they're raising money. You remember dancing?
Yeah.
When you were here as a student?
We did dance.
Well, what we have coming up now is a Whiplash clip.
Ooh, Whiplash.
You remember Whiplash?
Whiplash
that was done, that was like the first film
Wild West.
You remember watching Whiplash, don't you?
I watched Whiplash a couple times. Actually, I was here for the premiere of Whiplash.
Yeah?
Yeah. Right in the audience.
What'd you think of it?
Pretty interesting. It was a cool movie for its time. I mean, there was not a whole lot of special effects and things like that that kids are used to now, but...
So what would you prefer for you specifically? Would you like to, if you had a choice between watching Whiplash and dancing, what would you like to do?
Are you asking me out? To watch Whiplash or to dance with me?
I don't know. I guess it depends on how you take it.
Oh. What?
Just pick one for the sake.
Personally, I'd rather go in the Odeon and listen to some music.
Yeah?
But Whiplash is really good.
Are you going to be dancing in there later? You going to go tear it up with some of the...
I'm going to be cutting the rug. You guys don't want to watch that. If you see me there, just switch a shot there. You don't want to watch me dance.
We'll hook up with you later on. We'll get... maybe you and Mr. Abbott can do the waltz or the tango or something like that.
Me and Mr. A, we're going to do the tango.
Mr. A, you and Tim are going to do the tango later.
We're going to tango in the Odeon, Mr. A.
A tango?
A tango, that's what they asked. It was a special request.
Someone called in and requested it. I think it was
they're going to write like a $1,000 check if they saw us tangoing. You can bid on me and Mr. Abbott tangoing in the Odeon.
First caller, and we also trying to get Bill Jones a date.
Bill Jones, oh yes.
Bolts on your head?
I don't know Bill. No? I don't know Bill, but if anybody knows anybody that would like to date Bill, please call up 659-4696.
So you don't know what he looks like?
No, I haven't.
Picture an onion.
Okay.
You have a visual image of an onion?
Peeled or unpeeled?
Unpeeled.
Okay.
Make it bulbous.
Make it what?
That's what he looks like. Bulbous onion head.
Bulbous onion head.
It's unpeeled. There it is. Make it bulbous. That's what he looks like.
Bulbous
onion head. Hey, okay. Well, look, we'll try to talk to Bill maybe later on in the show, give him a call if we can, something like that. But right now it's Whiplash, and we'll be right back.
Whiplash.
Roger. Just came from the docks, buddy. That's all live. It's about 8.
Roger.
Right.
kids. Pretty shaken up. Thelma? Pretty bad.
Are you sure you didn't see anybody?
I told you before, bud. I got pulled into the back room and knocked on the head. That's all I know.
He didn't have to see anybody, Sheriff. Both me and you know it's El Diablo and his gang.
I know you're right, but we've got no real proof.
What more proof do we need? Two men in the field dead and another one injured?
Bud, this can't go on much longer.
Bud, when I was elected mayor of this town, I made a promise to the people. That promise was to make this town a safe one. And when I appointed you, Sheriff, you took an oath. And that is to say that you were to abide by the laws set forth by our forefathers. And you've done a fine job. Diablo is an exception.
Fine. And do you want to go arrest him? How about if I give you my badge and you go and arrest him?
But there are two men dead, one wounded, and Elmer laying back at the store half dead. We can't stand here and go to each other's throats. We've got to go after El Diablo.
He's right, Sheriff.
I can't bend the law for some guy that just comes in here.
But not back east. The law doesn't work the same out here.
But
I've known you for a long time, bud. Ever since you were deputy of this town. I've never ever seen you back down from a man, but that's what I think you're doing now.
Sometimes it takes more courage not to draw a gun, Roger.
I'm not asking you to go out there and shoot El Diablo. I just want you to run him out of town. It's the only alternative.
Do you know where he is now?
Nah, but sure shooting, he's somewhere in this town.
Hey, bro, look at us. We'll let you know.
Very pretty place.
Yes, my father used to bring me out here when I was a little girl. We used to go wading in the creek.
You'd like to go wading now?
Hardly. Toby, at the picnic, were you really gonna shoot that man?
I don't know.
Are you mad because I stopped you?
No.
Toby, Billy says there's a place down the streamway where the water's a lot deeper than it is here, and you can catch trout this big. You want to come along?
No, we might be down later, right?
Okay, come on. Are you going to kill El Diablo?
After we left the farm, and even after I met Tom Chafin, that's all that was on my mind. But now, I don't know.
But you're no killer.
But they shot my paw.
They're mean, cruel men. And I don't want anything to happen to you.
Would it mean that much?
Yes.
Come on.
the music?
Oh, we're having a good old time here. We're just working on there.
I used to try and get people to help me learn my lines, and my mother said, son, you've got to do it yourself. You've got mm-hmm. to figure everything out for yourself, and nobody can tell you, and I finally figured out I was on my own. There are some people who will come out of here fanatically in love with film, and they may be tomorrow Steven Spielbergs. Steven Spielberg may be in this building right now, or a girl. I mean, I'm not trying to be funny, but you all know that. That's true. I know that's true. And so, of course it's a good idea.
I guess I had no intentions working as an actor. I had no training as an actor. And I got involved with Ed Wood, the man who, you know, produced Plan 9 from Outer Space. We got to know Ed Wood back in 1948, and at that time, when I met Ed Wood, he told my brother and I, he was already a movie producer, but we found out he's yet to make a movie.
What do you think about Syndicate?
Yeah, I'd like to come back.
Yeah?
Sure, I'd like to come back. I mentioned maybe perhaps you guys can use me in a film sometime in the near future.
Why not?
You know, an actor's an actor, right? This is incredible. I think Syndicate I had no idea what to expect. And when we came here and we were taken on this tour, I was amazed. It truly amazed. And I think it's wonderful. All of you are starting out here, and if you carry on your careers, your foundation is absolutely magnificent. I think you're all wonderful.
Oh, we're live. Welcome back. Hey, we were just talking, continuing our conversation with Tim, and he was explaining to us why things in the mirror seem closer than they appear, what that whole deal is about. We figured that out, so we're having a good conversation. You know, we'll check back with Tim later on. We'll get the whole bumper-to-bumper spiel and... Yeah, I'll have a good time.
Okay, that sounds good. Where am I going?
You're not going anywhere. If you don't, we can sit there.
Okay.
I'm not kicking you out or anything.
I'll just hang here.
Well, just relax and calm down.
I'm cool.
We have a clip we want to share with you. You know, as you see, the kids are dancing. You remember dancing? You used
dancing,
to dance,
yeah.
Didn't you?
I still do at certain points.
Yeah.
Usually closer to like 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock. I usually.
Yeah. Why so late?
I don't know. I just get a lot of energy at that point.
Yeah. When do you start? Like 7?
7. By the time you hit one, you're all energized?
No, it's just at about, like, you know, between 11:30 and 12 o'clock, and then 1 o'clock, and go out and dance. It's just a good time. No one, like, really awake at the very late hours of the evening. Tom, you know, you've been out there with me a couple times. You're a real good dancer. He's a good dancer. Look out, girls. He's good.
Just gonna have to rip tear that up. Hey, we have a video. Oh, sorry, we're not allowed to move. Sorry.
Oh, wait.
Oh, show us some moves? If you wish I could show you some moves, I would set this whole place on fire like that. I showed you some. You show us some moves. Show us some dance moves, man. You're out there much more than I am.
No, it's too early, man. Told you, 1 o'clock.
What about this?
1 o'clock, guys, live right here. What's
that? One of them. Do one of them.
Do the worm, man.
See that?
You can do that.
Do the worm.
Why not?
What do I look like? A snake.
You want to watch it, don't you?
Okay. I'm a bird. I'm gonna do the worm. Give me a break. Do
the funky chicken. You're good at that.
Do the funky chicken. You do the funky chicken.
He does the funky chicken.
What, do you think I want to do the funky chicken?
He's good at the funky chicken.
What's your dance? What are you good at? What do you like to dance?
White man's overbite. No, I'm good at that. I'm really good at that one.
All right, we're on tape. I'm sorry to cut you off on your overbite problem. Yeah, I'll see a dentist. But it's a Syndicate video. We'll be back.
Syndicate Television Theater. We'll double your pleasure with two scenes from Syndicate's soap opera, The Lives We Lead. And you'll see more of Syndicate's classic space thrower, Odyssey Through Time. And the Tyro Kids will tell you what they've been up to, and you'll get a sneak peek at this year's Syndicate's rock concerts. All that and more coming up next on Syndicate Television Theater.
Meet Casey Kuhn, a Syndicate student for over 6 years. Casey's responsible for Syndicate's television show, Syndicate Theater. He's in charge of producing this show every week. Syndicate Theater airs on 5 different cable networks throughout Montgomery County. Casey wears many hats as a producer, as you will soon find out for yourself.
Over the summer, we lost the one editor. I became a sole editor, and then we took John Simonetta came on and worked with me. And over the course of the year, we changed from just showing shows to putting together spots which described everything. when we're viewing our tapes and going over the spots to see what we can use, we're looking for, we want to make sure it's good camera work, good technically, no glitches in the tape. We also want to make sure, to the best of our ability, that no one's stuttering or messes up the lines which they want to have. No, that was good. That was good. No. We'll do it one more time. That was good, except at the end, you went... You gotta save it. You gotta hold it, okay?
It wasn't good because I looked at the camera at the wrong time.
Hi, I'm Chris Crawling right now. Thank you for joining us this week. And as always, you're over. Or you can give us a call at 659-469-7.
I've worked up until close to 1 o'clock on, maybe 12:30, close to 1 o'clock on certain Syndicate theaters where there have been maybe a lot of graphics involved or such. Really depends. There's a lot of shows where I can do this show really quickly because everything's just assembling. Then there's other shows where I've got a bunch of voiceovers to do and a bunch of setups. This show's going to take a little longer. I've got a bunch of voiceovers, setups, and music to add, so it'll take a little longer than usual. Sometimes I can get it done in about an hour and a half. Sometimes it'll take 2 hours or so.
School days, school days. Up in the morning and out to school. We all know that not every kid enjoys going to school.
Hi, I'm Chris Rowling. Right now we're going to keep the show going with two more episodes of The Lives We Lead.
Why are you using that chuck?
Because John's my friend. And I think it's a really good video. John's proud of it, so I want to make sure everyone gets to see it.
We'll double your pleasure with two scenes from Syndicate soap opera, The Lives We Lead. This week on Syndicate Television Theater. We'll double your pleasure with two scenes from Syndicate soap opera, The Lives We Lead.
Three, two... No, wait. Five, four... I like the format. It's not, you know, some of the shows are long and drawn out. But I like the format where you have someone there, you know, setting it up. Before it, when you had just the pieces, it got...
Thank you.
1996, and they were just dancing, you know, they were just raising money dancing and just having a good time. You remember what it was like, just dancing, having a good time?
The dance marathon is pretty cool, and now it's Seneca Day, graduated on the Seneca Day.
Excuse me. We had a report that there was something going on out here that isn't too good.
Yeah, nothing that concerns you. Thanks a lot.
Could you tell me where Willow Grove is?
It's been hitting the sauce, I think, a little bit.
Yeah.
You've been
he went out for happy hour.
You
just got back.
He's even happier ever for Bob. Oh, he's dancing.
He's dancing. He missed the dance.
Dance.
Uh-oh.
Yo, buddy, I've seen better bodies on Volkswagen. So keep it moving. Keep it moving. Thanks a lot.
Hey, you want to relocate here?
Yeah, let's, we're going to, if you
we're going to switch locations here
quick,
1 minute.
Change locations.
Okay, ready? Okay.
All right. Okay, well, we're still live. It's Seneca Day.
We're back.
96. And we were just talking about what it was like dancing and having a good time. And we were students. We did the whole thing, and, you know, it was a lot of fun.
It was a whole lot of fun. We had a good time. Really good time. The kids all got together. Everything went really smoothly, as it is going really, really good today. I left my gaffer. I need a new gaffer out here if anybody wants to come down.
How about
Bob?
VW over here.
Volkswagen? Is he a bus or a Beetle? wait, he's yanking my cord.
How am I doing?
Hey, you're doing good. Hey, good job.
Easy there,
easy.
Founder.
All right.
We have a, what's the video we have? We have a, you remember doing the rock concerts and everything?
Oh, rock
this
concerts
is
were
probably,
incredible.
Probably one of the best rock concerts to come out of Syndicate this year. And we're going to go to that. And then, who knows, we'll come back to another location. Maybe we'll go back, see the kids dance.
Who sings this song, anyhow?
Who sings Jungle Boogie? Cool in the Gang.
Cool in the Gang. Is that one from,
Well, here it is. You take a look, and we'll come back. And
Pulp Fiction. Pulp Fiction.
live at here, 1996 Syndicate Day. We're here with Brandon and Dan. They just took over the dance. Brandon, how are you going to start things off for your time?
I'm thinking, you know, mellow, maybe the hustle. Sound good? Here we go.
Okay. Let's take it in right now. Go ahead. Okay, here at Syndicate, every year we have a big dance at the end of Syndicate Day. Syndicate Day, it just gets us ready for our big summer program. And this year, the name of it is The Man with the Glass Eye. If you want to help us with our program, you want to pledge us, our number is 659-4696, and any pledge that you got will help us out a lot. So let's just see what the kids are doing on the dance floor right now.
Get them dancing, come on.
Come on, guys!
People, it's a lot easier to move around. The Odeon was so big, you just like, it's kind of like, hey. So, you know.
Okay, now we're going outside to Tom or Mr. Clark. Okay, let's go out there.
Thank you for that. And we're joined outside with Larry the Love Machine. Hi, Larry. Thanks for joining us.
He's been hanging out
with us for about the last hour, telling us what a Don Juan he is and how he's kind of romancing everyone. So I asked him a couple minutes ago. I said, Larry, Love Machine, what, he said you had about 5,000 different lines that, you know, the women just fall all over themselves for. Your best pickup line out of 5,000 was?
Imagine yourself you was in the Pathmark ice cream section. I told her this, that you are so hot that you can melt all this ice cream in less than 5 minutes.
It's an old one. Hi, Tom.
Hey, Bob. Bob, we're bringing Bob in. Bob's
I got bored, so I thought I'd come in and join you. So
Bob's the resident dating expert. What do you, it'll be like a little panel discussion here for a couple minutes. What do you think about Larry's love, you know, his line? You don't like it?
Terrible.
No?
Oh, I had your girl laughing.
Laughing?
Yeah, I had her laughing.
So what do you think?
I don't think. Gets me in trouble.
What do you think about his line?
It's a tie. I don't think the line was very good. I like it. It's a nice tie.
What? How about you? Pickup line for you when you were his age and you were out having a good time?
I don't have any because I'm just such a nice guy that they all like me.
Yeah, right.
You like me, don't you?
Yeah, but I won't go out with you.
I
don't blame you.
I tell you the most romantic thing I did about 2 months ago.
It's a family show.
No, it's all good. It's all good.
All right, we're listening.
I wait, man, we had this African-American thing. I waited until it was my time to go up. After we did a little play and everything, I took the microphone, had on the big speakers and everything, and proposed to her in front of 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th graders, and the crowd went wild.
What do you mean you proposed to her?
I proposed to her on her knee, on my knee, and everything, just me and my girlfriend.
That's cool. Did she say yeah?
Yeah, 5 hours later, but...
Well, that's what I
you gotta work that for 5 hours?
Yeah, she was speechless.
Bob, you back know, in your day, would you ever work out here? For 5 hours?
No. 2-3 minutes.
Such a great conversation we're having.
I know, and it's awful. Why don't we raise some money?
Yeah, hey, what do you say we raise some money? Are you up for raising some money?
Yeah, I'm up for raising some money.
Use your charm and your debonair and tell the people out there to donate. You know, use your best charm and try to get people to donate to Syndicate.
Prizes. We still got those Eagles.
If I do not see you donate, I will come to your house and knock on your door so I can get some money out of all of y'all.
We need money.
Hey, there you go. You heard it first from Larry the Love Machine, and if it comes out of Larry's mouth,
it's got to be,
you know,
be true.
It's got to be true. It's like that whole, the whole people talk, he listens kind of what a commercial is. Hey, we're going to take a break for a moment, and when we come back, we have a very special interview next hour. We have more videos, more fun.
See you.
So stick around. Syndicate Day 96 is coming right back.
Is teaching the golden rule, American history and practical math. You study them hard and hoping to pass, working your fingers right down to the bone, and the guy behind you won't leave you alone. Ring, ring goes the bell, the cook in the lunchroom's ready to sell. You're lucky if you can find a seat. You're fortunate if you have time to eat. Back in the classroom, open your books.
Welcome back, Syndicate Day 1996. We're coming to you live from our live on tape, actually, from our studios in Willow Grove. Feel free to give us a call tonight, 659-4696. We are a nonprofit kids organization, and we specialize in teaching kids the art of communications, all aspects. So give us a call. Syndicate has been a fixture in this community for the last 20 years. And we hope to be going strong for another 20. And we can only do it with your support. So feel free anytime during tonight's broadcast to call us, make a pledge, help out our program. And if you're wondering what happens when you call in at Syndicate, well, this is what'll happen. Hold on one sec here. Calling Syndicate.
Syndicate, may I help you?
Hi, Mrs. Weaver. It's Tom.
Hi, Tom. How are you?
How are you? We're just calling to see what the procedure is if someone were to call in and make a donation. It's pretty simple, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Tell us about what information you need when people call in.
Well, we'd like to know who is calling, and we ask if they watch us on television, which we are assuming they are. We'd like to know how much they want to contribute. And we'd like them to give us the amount and their name and their address. And if they want to put it on a credit card, they can give us that information. Or they can give us a check, and we will contact them, and we will certainly see if their name is announced over TV and that they are acknowledged, their Syndicate donation is acknowledged.
Now, that sounds pretty simple. Isn't it true that someone within the last hour actually called in for a date with Bill Jones?
Yes, they did.
Now, that was a serious call, was it not?
As far as I know.
Now, from your memory, from what you can remember, what actually was said during that conversation?
First of all, Desiree, who she did not give me her name right away, but she asked to speak with Tom McGill. And I said, that he was not available right then and asked to take a message. And she said that it was Desiree calling and that she would like to have a date with Bill. And that she would call.
Sorry. Go ahead, I'm sorry. They would like a date with Bill?
She would like to have a date with Bill. And that she would call you back.
Okay, well, Desiree, if you're watching, give us a call, 659-4696. We can maybe put you on the air, maybe, but we can definitely try to hook you up with Bill Jones. And Bill, if you're watching, call in for Desiree. Maybe we can do like a little conference call. You know, I feel like Chuck Woolery today. Well, thanks for taking time to talk to us, Mrs. Weaver. And if Desiree calls in again, you know, we'll try to put her through, take some more information, and maybe we can hook her up with Bill Jones.
I sure hope she does.
Okay.
And lots of calls.
Excuse me?
We'll try to get you lots of calls.
Great. Lots of calls for Bill and lots of calls for...
donations to Syndicate.
Exactly. And we have to have donations to keep the program running. And it is a good program, is it not?
It certainly is. I've been involved a long time, and it's a great organization.
How long are you going to be working the phones tonight?
I will probably be here until the end of our going on at 10 o'clock.
Great. So you're manning the phones?
Pretty much so, with relief now and then.
Okay, well, thanks, Mrs. Weaver. Maybe we'll check in with you a little bit later on and see how everything's going.
Okay, fine.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Tom.
Bye. Mrs. Jean Weaver, CineKid staff member. That's how easy it is. You give us a call, 659-4696. Talk to Mrs. Weaver, take down a little information, make a very generous donation, and there you go, and it's even tax deductible. Well, let me tell you what we have coming up this hour. We have another world premiere video from the CineKid students. It's called I'm on the Case. That's going to run in just a few minutes. We have an interview with Mr. Tom Mert and a very special interview with CineKid graduate Tim Bancroft. That's all coming up this hour. Plus, we have a lot more interviews, a lot more phone calls, a lot more fun later on in the evening. But right now, it's I'm on the Case, and we'll be right back.
This way, guys. Rod, Kit,
fine.
Doc, please have a seat, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming with such a short
fine,
notice.
Yeah.
You know, with the rain and the storms and everything. Could you two please maybe wait out in the...
Von Hoovenhausen!
Anything I can hear, my nephew and his associate can hear.
Sure, okay.
Look, Rod, I'm going to be paying $1 million in less than a week from a painting that was stolen out of my warehouse about less than a year ago. and we don't handle those kind of insurance claims here. I'm begging you, please take the case, Rod, please.
I might feel,
I'll think about it.
Thanks a lot.
Got it.
Yes. We need one table for three people.
Your usual, sir.
That's the one.
That table is good.
Oh, you can say that again. You can say that again. You know, I've been really considering taking up this case. Might be good publicity for my book.
Yeah, take the case. I mean, you'll be famous.
My advice, don't matter whether solve case. Only thing matter, make cool million Deutschmark.
You're right. I didn't even think of that. See, I don't know. I can go either way.
Rod Raven! It's Rod Raven!
Here you go.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. You're so handsome. Your menu's in your orders.
Yeah.
Told me.
It's about time, you know?
Hey. On your way.
I think it might be poison.
Das, could it be true?
This is really a tough case.
It is.
Here's the file. Everybody's clean.
Bard!
Hey, Dries! George, Terry, and Reggie.
Reggie?
We're all clean. Bill, on the other hand, has a really big drug problem.
Oh.
Hi. Oh, Rod, this is Joe Adams. He's been the head detective on this case.
I have no idea what is going on. Everybody at the warehouse is clean.
Well, I for one am baffled. You with the jewel! Drop the broom!
Anyway, this is where we keep most of the stuff up around there, and,
some more stuff over there.
Hey, Bill!
Hey!
How's it going? How did you just sign this?
Oh, good.
Hey, that's a shame what happened last year with that painting and that cop getting shot.
Hick, boy.
That's a real shame.
Oh, hey,
what do you do?
There you go.
I'll see you Sunday.
Sunday.
Yeah.
Bye. It's George. He's been working here for about 10 years now.
Yeah, have all your people been working here that long?
Yeah, sort of. But we have two part-timers right now. We're doing pretty good. What's your name again?
Dawson's the kid.
Yeah, okay, I'm catch. Anyway.
Hey, boss!
Hey! Pat, how's it going?
It's all right, boss.
Pat, this is my two new friends here. I'm gonna shake some hands.
Hi, Thornton.
Hi. Fine.
All right, anyway. Pat, take it down to the mailroom, okay?
Okay, boss.
Thank you very much.
No problem,
okay,
boss.
Yeah. Anyway, that's Pat. Do a good job.
Well, where's the
other guy? Doug, yes, well, Doug. Doug is down in the mailroom right now, and let me finish showing you around. Oh, right there, this way.
Why would someone want to steal that painting?
I don't know.
I mean, it wasn't guarded or anything?
No, we never had a problem with security before. Doug, this is Doc, and Doc, that's Doug. No, he doesn't shake hands well. Thank you, Doug. Bye, Doug.
Bye, his pretty lady.
He's so sweet.
Doesn't he work here?
Well, we hired him about a year ago as a part-timer.
Mm. How much is that painting usually worth?
About a million. Excuse me a moment.
Wait a minute. You keep paintings that much in this place?
Oh, well, yeah, we always have things of value.
No alarms or anything?
Can I call you back? Okay. No, it's never been a problem.
Can I have some files on the workers here?
Sure, hold on. Mr. Lester told me you might be buying to have these ready for you. Here you go.
All
right, thanks. Sure. Bye-bye.
All right, see you. Talk to you later. There you is. There's the information that you wanted from Detective Johnson, yeah, from the big precinct, yeah. There you go.
Mr. Lester, I'm going to need your full cooperation.
Anything, anything. Why, what can I do? Have you uncovered something?
Yes, I believe I know who stole the painting and murdered your watchman. Come on, let's go!
Wait a minute, shouldn't we do something with him?
Yeah, pick him up, hurry up.
Man. Come
on. I said hurry up!
That's Doug Williams stole the painting, yeah. McBride. No, I know who did it. It's Charles Falcon.
The insurance agent?
Yes. I stole the painting, because I don't have any money and you have all the money. I couldn't have gotten away with it except for you snooping kids.
Yeah.
Take him, her, away, boys.
Take her downtown.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
How about some Chinese?
Or bratwurst, man.
Yeah, why not?
Lester?
Mr. Lester?
Up here.
Oh my God, the voices are back. This time they're in English.